Giving me an opportunity to share God's words for today's meditation. I'm gonna read a word from the Bible. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 3. This vision is for a future time. It describes the end and it will be fulfilled. For if it seems slow in coming, patiently wait for it. For it will surely take place, it will not be delayed. Let's pray. God, thank you for the promise from the Bible. Bless us with these Bible words. Amen. All of you will have a vision. It will come true. If it may take a long time, days, months, weeks, years, but no matter how long it takes, it will always come true. No matter how much time it takes, it will always come true. I would like to remind about Joseph's story. Joseph had a vision about his brothers bowing down to him. His brothers were very jealous. They throwed him in a well and they sold him as a slave. He got put in jail for some years. And after a few years, he got out of jail and his vision came true. He was the new minister of Egypt. Don't talk about your problems more than God's promises. Don't talk about the devil more than God's promises. Because if you start speaking God's promises, you're actually allowing the Holy Spirit of God make God's promises true in your life. Believe for that. Thank God for that. Begin to rejoice and say, God, thank you for your promise. Thank you for your promise. The Nehemiah started saying, God, you promised to Abraham, you promised to the prophets that you will do such and such a thing. Now the walls are broken down. But I thank you, you will keep your promise. I thank you, I rejoice. Some people say, God, I'm not worthy to be blessed. I'm guilty. I'm unworthy. But hey, you will be blessed. You know why? Because you're made by the blood of Jesus. You're about God's plan. And for that, God will bless you.